हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल टेक्निकल नॉलेज विद इंजीनियर्स। आई एम स्टूडेंट ऑफ प्रियदर्शनी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग नागपुर एंड आई एम हियर टू टेल यू सम इम्पॉर्टेंट नोट्स ऑन द टॉपिक वाटर एंड इट्स ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ अप्लाइड केमिस्ट्री सेकेंड सेमेस्टर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द टॉपिक। लाइक एयर, वाटर इज वन ऑफ द फ्यू बेसिक मटेरियल विच इज ऑफ प्राइम इम्पॉर्टेंस फॉर द प्रिजर्वेशन ऑफ लाइफ ऑन दिस अर्थ। वी ऑल आर अवेयर अबाउट द यूजेस ऑफ वाटर। We use water for drinking, cooking, bathing and for farming etc. But few know the importance of water as an engineering material. As an engineering material, water is used for producing steam in boilers to generate hydroelectric power, furnishing steam for engines, for construction of concrete structures, for manufacturing purposes and as a solvent in chemical process. Now we will see sources of water. The main sources of water are rainwater, river water, spring or well water, sea water. First, rainwater. Rainwater is the purest form of natural water. However, it dissolves considerable amount of gases like CO2, SO2, NO, NO2, etc. and suspended solid particles from atmosphere during its journey through it and become polluted. River water. River are formed by rain and spring waters. During its flow over the surface of land, it dissolves minerals of the soil such as chlorides, sulfates, bicarbonates of sodium, calcium, magnesium ion, etc. Third, spring or well water or lake water. It contains constant chemical composition. The minerals present in the lake water in the dissolved form and high quantity of organic matter. Fourth, sea water. It is the most impure form of natural water. It contains larger percentage of dissolved salt, above 3.5%, out of which 2.6% is sodium. The NaCl which is present in the dissolved form in seawater will come out as NaCl crystal due to evaporation of the seawater. The other salt present in the seawater are sulfates of sodium, bicarbonates of potassium, magnesium, calcium, bromides of potassium, magnesium, etc. Underground water. Spring and well water are the underground water sources. They are generally clearer in appearance due to the filtering action of the soil. They contain more of the dissolved salt generally. Underground water is of high organic purity. Now we will see impurities in water. There are three types of impurities. First, dissolved impurities. Dissolved impurities may be organic or inorganic. Inorganic impurities like the carbonates, bicarbonates, sulfates, chlorides of calcium, magnesium, iron, potassium and aluminium. And organic impurities like organic water products, amino acid, proteins, etc. Suspended impurities. It is also of two types, organic and inorganic. Inorganic impurities like sand and clay, and organic impurities like vegetable and animal matter. Third, biological impurities. Microorganisms like pathogenic bacteria, fungi, algae, etc. are the example of biological impurities. Now we will see disadvantages of water. The following are the disadvantages when hard water is used for various purposes. First, domestic use. Washing and bathing. Hard water does not form lather easily with the soap is wasted. Second, drinking. Hard water causes bad effect on our digestive system. Sometimes stone formation takes place in the kidney. Third, cooking. The boiling point of water is increased due to the presence of salts. Hence, more fuel and time are required for the cooking. Disadvantages of hard water in industrial uses. First, in textile industry. हार्ड वाटर कॉजेज वेस्टेज ऑफ सोप, प्रेसिपिटेट्स ऑफ कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम सोप एडहेर टू द फैब्रिक कॉजेज प्रॉब्लम. सेकेंड, पेपर इंडस्ट्री. कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम सॉल्ट इन वाटर में अफेक्ट द क्वालिटी ऑफ पेपर. थर्ड, शुगर. वाटर कंटेनिंग सल्फेट्स, कार्बोनेट्स, नाइट्रेट्स अफेक्ट द क्रिस्टलाइजेशन ऑफ शुगर. फोर्थ, फार्मास्यूटिकल इंडस्ट्री. हार्ड वाटर में फॉर्म सम अनडिजायरेबल प्रोडक्ट्स वाइल प्रिपरेशन ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल प्रोडक्ट. थर्ड एंड लास्ट डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ हार्ड वाटर इज स्टीम जनरेशन इन बॉयलर्स. फॉर स्टीम जनरेशन बॉयलर्स आर एम्प्लॉयड. इफ हार्ड वाटर इज यूज इन बॉयलर इट मे लीड टू द फॉलोइंग ट्रबल्स. बॉयलर कोरिजन, स्केल एंड स्लज फॉर्मेशन, प्राइमिंग एंड फोमिंग, कॉस्टिंग एम्ब्रिटलमेंट फार्मास्यूटिकल इंडस्ट्रीज. नाउ वी विल सी वॉट इज हार्ड वाटर एंड सॉफ्ट वाटर. हार्ड वाटर, दोज वाटर विच डज नॉट प्रोड्यूस एथर और वेरी लिटिल एथर विद अ सोप इज कॉल्ड हार्ड वाटर. सॉफ्ट वाटर, सॉफ्ट वाटर इडियली प्रोड्यूस अ लॉट ऑफ एथर व्हेन मिक्स्ड विद अ लिटिल सोप. The hardness of water is caused by the presence of dissolved salt such as bicarbonates, sulfates, chlorides and nitrates of bivalent metal ions like Ca2 plus Mg2. Now we will see what is soap. Soap is a sodium potassium salt of higher fatty acids like stearic, oleic and palmitic acid. When soap is mixed with a soft water, lather is produced due to stearic acid and a sodium stearate. We can see here in the reaction, sodium stearate plus H2O gives NaOH plus stearic acid. Then stearic acid plus sodium stearate gives the formation of lather. When soap come in contact with hard water, sodium stearate will react with the dissolved calcium and magnesium salts and produce calcium stearate or a magnesium stearate which is of white precipitate. We can see in these reactions. Now we will see different types of water have different degree of hardness. The different types of water are commercially classified on the basis of degree of hardness as follows. You can see this in the table. Now we will see types of hardness. There are two types of hardness. First, temporary hardness, also known as carbonate hardness. And second, permanent hardness, also known as non-carbonate hardness. First, temporary hardness. Temporary hardness is caused by two dissolved bicarbonates, salt like calcium bicarbonate and magnesium bicarbonate. The hardness is called temporary hardness because it can be removed easily by the means of boiling. When calcium bicarbonate is heated, it gives CaCO3 plus H2O plus CO2. Same in magnesium also. When magnesium bicarbonate is heated, it gives magnesium OH twice plus twice CO2. Second, permanent hardness. Permanent hardness of water is due to the dissolved chloride, sulfates and nitrates of calcium and magnesium. These salts are CaCl2, CSO4, CNO3 twice, MgCl2, MgSO4, MgNO3. This hardness cannot be removed easily by boiling. Hence, it is called permanent hardness. Only chemical treatment can remove this hardness. We can see here, total hardness of water is equals to temporary hardness plus permanent hardness. Now we will see degree of hardness. The concentration of hardness as well as non-hardness constituting ions are usually expressed in the term of equivalent amount of carbonate. Since this mode permits the multiplication and division concentration when required. The choice of CaCO3 in particular is due to the molecular weight. M is 100, equivalent weight equals to 50. And moreover, it is an insoluble salt that can be precipitated in water treatment. Now we will see determination of hardness of water by EDTA method. This is a complexometric method where ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid is the reagent. EDTA forms complexes with the different metal ions at a different pH. Calcium and magnesium ions form complexes with EDTA at pH from 9 to 10. To maintain the pH from 9 to 10, NH4Cl, NH4OH buffer solution is used. Fourth, an alcoholic solution of Irochrome Black Tea, EBT, is used as an indicator. The disodium salt of EDTA under the trade name Triplex-3 is used for the complexation. Now we will see boiler troubles. Water finds a great use in various industries for generation of steam in boilers. When water is continuously evaporated to generate steam, the concentration of the dissolved salt increases progressively, causing bad effect for steam boilers. The following are the boiler troubles that arises during the generation. First, priming and foaming. Second, costing embrittlement. Third, boiler corrosion. Fourth, scale and sludge formation. Now we will see external treatment, also known as softening of water. The removal of hardness causing salt from water is called as softening of water. The three main industrial methods employed for softening of water are lime soda process, zeolite or permutate process, and ion exchange or demineralization process. We will see one by one in detail. First, lime soda process. This process is based on converting the soluble calcium and magnesium salts into insoluble calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide precipitate by addition of calculated amount of lime and soda. The precipitate are removed by filtration. Any free dissolved CO2 and acids are also removed by this process. Second, zeolite or permutate process. Zeolite is hydrated sodium aluminium silicate. Its general formula is Na2O.Al2O3.XSiO2.YH2O. Here, as X equals to 2 to 10 and Y equals to 2 to 6. Natural zeolites are generally non-porous. The artificial zeolite is called as permutate. These are prepared by heating together with a chain clay, feldspar and soda ash. These are porous and have greater softening capacity than natural zeolite. Third, ion exchange process or demineralization process. Ion exchange resins are insoluble, cross-linked and long-chain organic polymer. The functional groups attached to the chain can exchange hardness producing cation and anion present in the water. Now we will see internal treatment, also known as conditioning of water. The softening of water carried out inside the boiler is called as conditioning or internal treatment of water. In this process, the hardness causing dissolved salts were prohibited. First, by complexing the hardness causing soluble salt by adding appropriate reagent. Second, by precipitating the scale forming impurities in the form of sludges, which can be removed by blowdown operation. Third, by converting the scale forming scale into compounds which stay in dissolved form and do not cause any trouble to the boilers. Fourth, all internal treatment method must be followed by blowdown operation so that accumulated sludges are removed. Now we will see important internal conditioning method. First, colloidal conditioning. The scale forming in low pressure boiler is prevented by the addition of kerosene, tarnin, agar-agar, etc., which get coated over the scale forming precipitates. These form loose, non-sticky deposit that can be removed by the blowdown. Second, carbonate conditioning. The hard water and a strong adherent scale formed due to the CSO4 are avoided by the addition of sodium carbonate to the boiler water and this is called carbonate conditioning. The CSO4 is converted to CaCO3, which is loose sludge, and it can be removed by the blowdown. Third, Calgon conditioning. Sodium hexamate phosphate is called as Calgon. This forms soluble complex compound with CSO4, which causes no boiler troubles. The treatment of boiler water with Calgon is called as Calgon conditioning. Electrical conditioning. Sealed glass bulbs containing mercury connected to a battery are set rotating in the boiler. When water boils, mercury bulb emits electrical discharge, which prevents scale-forming particles to adhere or stick together to form a scale. And fifth, radioactive conditioning. In this type of conditioning, radioactive salt is the form table are placed inside a boiler water at a few points. The radiation emitted by the tablet of radioactive material prevents scale formation. Now we will see desalinization of brackish water. Water containing high concentration of dissolved solids with a peculiar salty or brackish taste is called as brackish sea water. Is an example of brackish water containing about 3.5% of dissolved salt. This water cannot be used for domestic and industrial application unless the dissolved salt are removed by the desalination. Commonly used method for brackish water are electrodialysis and reverse osmosis. Now we will see uses of water in domestic use and treatment of water for municipal supply. The following are the specification of water drinking purpose. This water should be clear, colorless and odorless. Water must be free from pathogenic bacteria and dissolved gases like H2S. Optimum hardness of water must be 125 ppm and pH must be from 7 to 8.5. Turbidity in drinking water should not exceed till 25 ppm. The recommended maximum concentration of total dissolved solid in potable water must not exceed till 500 ppm. Now, treatment of water for municipal supply. The treatment of water for drinking purposes mainly includes the removal of suspended impurities, colloidal impurities, and harmful pathogenic bacteria. Various stages involved in purification of water for municipal supply. First, water comes from a source, then screening takes place, then aeration takes place, then sedimentation, then filtration, then disinfection, then storage and distribution takes place. This was all about water and its treatment. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked the video. Please do like and subscribe the video.